Welcome back to the Hollywood News Channel, where we update you with the latest news of the day.
Hello guys, and welcome back to the channel. Melania Trump is being alienated because she has forgotten her roots after failing to return to her home country in over 10 years, according to the Croatian singer. Miki Solus recently dedicated his song Melania to the First Lady of the United States, in which he urged the Slovenian Rose to help save this world. Speaking to Total Croatian News, Mr. Solus said, "I find it interesting that Melania has completely lost contact with her Slovenian homeland and the entire Balkan region. She has reportedly not been in Slovenia for 10 years, let alone to her birthplace. She's alienated, and I want to remind her through my song to think about her roots a little, who she is and where she comes from. And to influence her husband a little, since she is in such a powerful position to do something good for this world." Mr. Solus, who heavily criticized US President Donald Trump in his song, also jokingly admitted to feeling concerned about potential repercussions for dedicating a song to the FLOTUS. He continued, "I'm a little scared. I'm thinking, what if someone deletes my YouTube video in 10 days? What if the CIA or the FBI come to my door, but I hope there won't be any retaliation. I would be powerless in that situation. I could fight and sue against this or that, but against the FBI or the US, I don't stand a chance. The song will be gone and maybe I will be too. I'll disappear." Melania Trump was born Melania Knav in the Slovenian city of Novo Mesto near the Croatian border. After working as a model for several fashion agencies in Milan and Paris, the now First Lady moved to the United States in 1998. The US President revealed in 2005 he had met Melania at a New York Fashion Week event in 1998 after he was invited by a friend to meet a supermodel working at the gathering. Speaking to TV host Larry King, Donald Trump said, "I went crazy. I was actually supposed to meet somebody else. There was this great supermodel sitting next to Melania. I was supposed to meet this supermodel. They said, 'Look, there's so and so.' I said, 'Forget about her. Who is the one on the left?' And it was Melania." Discussing the encounter, Ms. Trump said, "I knew who he was, but I didn't know about his life, about what was going on. I had my life. I didn't care about his. I wasn't starstruck." The First Lady admitted to having refused to give Donald Trump her phone number as he had arrived at the party with a different date, but accepted when he offered his contact details. The couple tied the knot in a lavish ceremony at the Episcopal Church in Bethesda by the Sea in Palm Beach, Florida in 2005, before holding a reception at Mr. Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort. The following year, they welcomed their only son, Baron Trump. The US President and Melania Trump lived separately for the first 5 months of his presidency due to reports suggesting the First Lady wanted their son to finish the school year in New York before moving to Washington. In the 2018 book Fire and Fire Inside the Trump White House, author Michael Wolff claimed he retreated to his own bedroom, the first time since the Kennedy White House that a presidential couple had maintained separate rooms. This was confirmed by US Weekly, which asserted that Melania refuses to share a bed with Donald, even on the rare occasions when they sleep in the same city. Thank you so much for joining us, and see you again in the next video. Bye!
Thank you for watching the Hollywood News. Don't forget to like and share the updates to the latest information of the day.